this man to Christ. Now, when I see this, I think of Leviticus 13:45, when it says they put a covering on their upper lip and would cry, unclean, unclean. They shut the door. Now the man is dead inside, died without Jesus Christ. This lady knows in a short time she'll be going out into eternity also. Now here's two ladies that sent for us, legs all bandaged up. They said nobody's been to see them in 10 years. We prayed with them. We'll see after a while at the leper clinic how these legs and feet look like under bandages like this. I heard somebody screaming and hollering outside one day, and I thought somebody's beating their wife up or something. I ran outside to see what was happening. That time this big old hog on a motorcycle to take him off to market. In America, we haul him in trucks, but over there, that time big old hog on a motorcycle down the road, they'll go with him, and I'll guarantee you that hog never forgot that ride as long as he lived. Now, the man in the middle with the glasses on was a good friend of mine, and I don't like to hear about anybody dying, but I thank God that we had part in getting this man saved is with the Lord Jesus. Now, tied behind this there are two great big old dogs. His livelihood was raising dogs, not for pets or watchdogs, but they raise them to eat over there like we do pork and beef. Now, I hope you've had supper already tonight because these next few slides are humdingers. So there's old Rover tied behind us, but here's old Rover. We're going to eat him that day. Paul says, we must become all things to all men to win some to Christ. Now, I've eaten, I sat down with the lepers 3 times, and I've ate dog meat. But now I'm an old boy from South Georgia, raised in East Tennessee, and I know what pork chickens are, but how'd you like to dig in old Rover chickens there? They don't waste nothing on a dog but the bark, and they're going to start recording that. That lady's golden tooth is shining up there. She's smiling. She's going to cook Rover for us. Now, if we hadn't eaten dog meat, I'm so glad it was this one instead of this one. I don't think I could have eaten this one. I was in this leper colony a few days ago, and I saw this dog. I said, buddy, I'm sure glad I never did have to eat to you. In darkness, raised in darkness, die in darkness, and go out into in darkness and the hell for all eternity, unless a missionary goes and tells them the good news of Jesus Christ, trust in a man-made image like this for salvation. Now, this is inside of a Buddhist temple yard. I'm going to take you step by step and show you what the Buddhists do to get their souls set free. The lady at the right is Dr. Kanchana, a medical doctor saved out of Buddhism 9 years ago, resigned the director of a Buddhist hospital to come and work with us full time. We thank God for Dr. Kanchana. I got a letter from her just yesterday, my wife told me. Now, there's live birds in a cage in the middle of the slide. There's plastic bags hanging up with turtles and eels and water in those bags. Now, the girl stood up so we could get a good picture of the bird in the cage. Now, behind us, they're selling lottery tickets back there. They also allow prostitution in the temple yard if they give some of the money to Buddha. They have no morals. So the girl stood up with the birds in the cage. Lady at the right, come over. You can see the money exchanging hands there. She's buying the birds in the cage. And then there's eels in plastic bags in the water, and she's going to purchase some turtles also. They go over. There's a big image of Buddha at the left. They're dedicating the birds, eels, and turtles to Buddha. Then they stand up and set them free. This is supposed to be setting their souls free, but we know that only Jesus Christ can set a soul free and nothing else. We'll go across the river, our road down to the river, and they're setting the turtles and eels loose. You can see the plastic bags around the girl's arm. Eels in there, she's knelt down turning the turtle loose. The girl standing up will turn her turtle loose, doing all of this thinking that it'll set their souls free. My, how they need to know about Jesus Christ, that he's the one that sets their souls free. Then going back into the Buddhist temple yard, here's the Buddha dancers. They dance 24 hours a day to their false god, to their dead god, Buddha. They dance for 8 hours, then there'll be other Buddha dancers come and relieve them. After 8 hours, there'll be new ones come to relieve them. 24 hours a day, these dancers dance to Buddha, praising him. My, we can't even, sometimes we get tired. We spend an hour in church sometimes.
Amen.
And then you see the incense going up in the middle of the slide. They're burning incense to Buddha. All the fruit offerings they brought, the pineapples, apples, and fruit, and the necklaces they brought to Buddha, still the Buddha dancers at the right. Now, this is one of their main services they're having. And there's Buddha up in the cage at the top, and then there's still all the offerings they're bringing to Buddha. Now this man, I watched him pray for 4 hours, just like this, to Buddha. And sometimes we think we're doing something if we pray for 5 or 6 minutes. But I timed this man for 4 hours. He sat like this praying to Buddha. He brought a hog head offering to Buddha, giving him all that he could. Now this is where they're putting real pieces of gold on the wood carved elephants. This is an image of power. They even pray to the elephants over there, thinking this even pleases Buddha. Now these Buddhism is very similar to Catholicism. Here's Buddhist nuns come up to me begging for money. But of course I didn't give them any money. I tried to tell them about Jesus Christ. Now this is inside of a Buddhist government leper colony, giving God the glory. I don't like to hear anybody say me or I, but God does the work. But God worked miracles, got me inside this Buddhist-controlled leper colony and preaching the gospel, and many lepers got saved, and they built the church here inside of a Buddhist leper colony. And my, what a testimony for Christ to have the cross of Christ taken up in a Buddhist leper colony. Now, January, we're going to have to enlarge this church. All the lepers can't come that wants to come to services. They had to walk the surfaces through the water until we built the walkway for them to walk the churches for many of these houses. Now these slides were just made a few days ago. I was preaching inside the leper colony, the men on one side of the service. These are leper men. These are leper women on the other side of the church building where we built the church there for them. Then a lady with her baby in her arms, deformity setting into her fingers. Now these children will have to live with mom and daddy until they get the disease. There's a beautiful little girl in her mother's arms. If you'll notice how black the little girl's nose is, I just finished preaching this Sunday morning, and I got them to hold the girl up so I could get a picture of her. And here she is walking home with her daddy after the service. This horrible disease of leprosy setting into her face. And church, if you don't send missionaries to go tell them the good news about Jesus Christ, who in the world is going to go? The old wino, the bartender, the harlot's not going to go. There's a great job for the body of Christ to do, and that's to take the gospel to the ends of the earth. Here's a little girl. This slide was made a few days ago, a leper girl with her leper mother inside the leper colony. This is her pastor that we're supporting there. We've got 5 leper churches built in Thailand, and we're supporting the leper pastors. Here's one of the leper pastors, a Trapadang, that we're paying to be the pastor there. Of course, they would do it without pay, but we want to take care of them as their full-time servants for God over there in the churches. Now, this little boy lives with this mama. He gets the disease, and part of her ministry is giving away artificial arms and legs. You see the legs on this leper mother here. She's lost her left leg to leprosy, but the little boy will have to live with mama that he gets the disease also. Now here's 3 little girls that told me, they said, we've never had a daddy. Would you be her daddy? And I said, I sure will. But they've got a better father than me. They've got a heavenly father now. All 3 of them have been saved. And the sad part about it, these little girls will never leave this leper colony alive. They're there the rest of their life. The girl at the right, you can see her left arm and hand and leg and foot, how swelled it is, how big they are. Now the foot bandaged up, we'll see at the leper colony clinic after a while, the ulcer that's beginning to set into a foot like this. Now the government let Dr. Consonant, her husband, myself, go into public schools and check children for leprosy. Here's a 7-year-old girl in the beginning stages. The first signs of leprosy is the pigmentation begins to turn white, and you can stick needles and pins in there and there's no feelings. Here's an 11-year-old girl, got the disease in the nose and the ears. And Dr. Continent starts treatment medically, but they always get the gospel of Jesus Christ before anything. A soldier came in to be checked. He's got the disease. A man came in out of the jungle to be checked with this little girl eating up with leprosy. Now, a street leper in Chiang Rai, an outcast, nobody will have anything to do with her whatsoever. She sleeps under cars at night behind store buildings. But I'm praying that we can get her saved and move her into the Christian leper colony. Now, if you'll notice a Mercedes Benz in the background, it seemingly contrasts with a street leper like this and a rich man's car, but this belongs to one of the warlords. Now, the law in North Thailand is what the warlords say. They are the drug dealers of opium and the runners and so forth. Up to 20 years ago, opium was the currency in North Thailand. Now, here's on the Laos border, inside of a Buddhist building. We're having a service this morning. We've got a church built there. We'll see it after a while. But these are lepers and children of lepers that we've won to Christ. Here's 5 pre-teenage Buddhist monks that come in to tell some of the lepers not to listen to what we're telling them about Jesus, not to leave their cult or religion, because it would bring a shame to Thailand if they changed their religion. And I know one thing, every time you start winning souls to Christ, the old devil is going to try to do something to stop it. It never fails. Here's playground equipment we brought in Bangkok, took 450 miles north to a leper colony, and because we had concern for the children, we were able to get in and preach. You can see the baptismal pool at the right, and then there's a church further to the right that we were able to build there. When many of these people to Christ, we'll see the church after a while. Now this is what it's all about, church. See his legs, his hands, getting the word of God to people like this that are outcasts. All these slides that we see tonight, I've made them myself. They're not borrowed, they're not bought. And as we met this man some years ago, won him to Christ, he told me in 7 years that he had leprosy, not a member of his family nor a friend had been to see him. As I move around this man and take pictures of him, I want you to see what this horrible disease does to the body as a type of sin, also what sin can do to the human. Moving around him, how the bottom part of him dropped him. The last thing this man told me when I talked to him alive, he says, "Brother Tommy, I sure want to just go ahead and die and be with Jesus. I cannot hardly stand this body I'm living in." Left arm's falling off, fingers off the right hand. End of his leg scabbing over so bad down there. And church, this is what it's all about. We don't try to change their culture. We do not try to make Americans out of them, but we do try to make born-again Christians out of them. And because the churches sent a missionary, because this church, Community Baptist, sent a missionary over there, this man's been saved. And he's got the Word of God in his hands. If a missionary had never went to this man, he'd have never got the Word of God, never been saved. And church, giving God all the glory, but if you don't touch them, you cannot hardly win them to Christ. I don't know how many lepers God's let me win by hugging them around the neck and saying, "God loves you and we love you." And then they'll listen when they know that you love them good enough to touch them like this. I went back to see my friends at the well 3 years ago. The man at the right said he's not with us anymore. Said God took him home. He died and went to heaven. But they said before he died, he told me about Jesus and I've been saved. Now the man at the left, while he was dying, won two people to Christ. And you see how it multiplies, church, when you send missionaries and they get a man saved and he starts telling people about Jesus, and it just multiplies. Because this church sent a missionary to tell the man at the left how to be saved, then he led two others to Christ. Now the man at the right that we're looking at is the same man that I'm baptizing right here. We baptized 20 lepers that day. The government would not let us baptize inside the leper colony. We had to rent a truck, go across Bangkok. And you talk about making an old cold-hearted Baptist shout when you follow a truck with 20 lepers in it, and they're singing "Amazing Grace, How Sweet the Sound That Saved a Wretch Like Me." Brother, that just about makes a Pentecostal out of you, I tell you. So here's a lady, a man right here that's blind, no fingers, that left Buddha to come to Jesus, not ashamed of Jesus. I'll never forget this lady as long as I live. She's blind, standing on nubs, no feet to stand on, got fingers tied on. When I baptized her, when brought her up out of the water, she said, "Preacher, what else did Jesus want me to do? I've been obedient. I tried to follow him in his death, burial, and resurrection, and I'll do anything else he wants me to do." And I thought, dear God, how I would love to hear Christians in America saying that today. And of course, we're Baptists. We do what the Bible teaches. We don't sprinkle, but we completely merge in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Here's the church we built on the Cambodian border, 60 miles in the jungle. This is where the elephants and tigers and snakes are all so bad. But we found this village of lepers that left society 10 years ago and built their village around the crematory. We took a pastor with us. We built the church up high like this because they just have two seasons in Thailand. The dry season, and then the wet season, the rainy season. Now during the rainy season, they go upstairs to worship God, but downstairs, in the dry season, they meet on the concrete slab. This is the church we prayed for $12,000 to build, and God sent it in 3 weeks. So we know that God's really in this. The day we dedicated the church to God, many doctors came from Bangkok because we found the lepers, and then there's many Buddhists there. We always welcome the Buddhists because we preach Christ to them. And then there's the lepers coming in the doorway. Now this is a hill tribe people I met about 4 years ago that have no morals. There's 100 villages of these people that not one missionary has ever been in their village. They have no morals. They swap their wives around every day like animals. They don't know what sin is. Every man has five or six wives apiece. And when I tried to lead them to Christ, you just cannot soul win over there like you do in America, because they say, what is heaven? What is hell? What is sin? But what broke my heart, they said, if somebody would come up here and take time and teach us what you're trying to tell us that we can understand, we'd all listen. 100 villages like this saying, send us a bread of life, send us a bread of life. But my, how ease and Zion we are. I was in this village last December when a mother had twins, and because they told me it brought a bad omen to their God, bad luck to the village, they killed both babies, took ashes and stuck down their throats and smothered them to death. And then because they brought bad luck to their village, they had to go out to the jungles and live a year. They'll be coming out next month out of the jungles. I hope I'm there to meet them. Well, I can. I'm going back in January, but I'll go back to the village and still try to win them to Christ when they come in out of the jungle. There's a hill tribe woman trying to give us opium and a pipe to smoke it in. Hill tribe man smoking his opium. They don't know anything's wrong with it. They have no morals whatsoever. This is the kitchen they cook in. Now, my co-worker and myself, we took a chalkboard in the mountains teaching the children about Jesus because they're so much easier to reach than their hard-hearted parents. Of course, the Holy Spirit can pierce any heart, but I like to fish where the fishing is easy also, where you can catch them and bite real easy. Now, this is the church we built. We can build a church like this for $2,000 in Thailand. That wouldn't even build the steps of the church in America. But over there, we've got three churches to build. We're looking forward to building in 1990 and two other leper colonies. So we can build a church like this for $2,000. There's a little boy, a twin that was born in the Hill Tribe Village. The mother and daddy killed the little sister's sister. But before they could kill the little boy, my co-worker got him out, and we're raising him at the leper colony now. There is infantigo around his mouth. He's well now, and he's getting fatter and fatter. They're really feeding him good and taking real well care of him. Here's Beulah Land Christian Leper Clinic in Bangkok. We bought this building for $3,000. We keep medicine in there, gospel tracts, Bibles, cassette tape players, and tapes of the Bible. And I don't know how many have been saved to come there to be checked for leprosy and get the gospel of Christ. Here's Dr. Kyneson at the right. Here's a 19-year-old Buddha girl. She and her friends, the one I told about last night, that sent for me to tell them who it was that made the lepers happy. At the left, she's 19 years old, got saved out of Buddhism, went home and won her mom and daddy to Jesus also. Now, she's on her staff over there. Dr. Kyneson at the right, the medical doctor, that's in charge of the medical distribution and also winning souls. And then that's her assistant there at the left. Her name is Kim Arpa, a Thai girl. Loves the Lord. Now, some of these people coming off the streets to be checked for leprosy, I'm going to show you what many of them look like when they come in. Leprosy being a type of sin. Without a sedative or a pain-killing shot, they're going to take this ulcer out of this man's foot, but he's waited too long. The end of his fingers are gone, big knots on his legs. When they reach this stage, really, there's no help for them and no hope. Can't do much for them. This is what the ulcers look like when many of them come in off the streets to be checked. Some people say, well, doesn't this really hurt? Well, surprisingly, it doesn't, because there's no feelings there. This is why they wait like this sometimes to come and get checked, because it's never hurt them. All the nerves are dead, but that foot will have to be amputated. Here's the ulcer that comes in. This man's foot will have to be amputated. And like sin, you cannot wash it away with soap and water. The blisters on the fingers will burst open when the scabs begin to set over. The fingers will go, the hands, the arms, etc., to the whole body rots and decays. This is what it looked like. The ladies that couldn't, I went and prayed with them at their house, all bandaged up. And young people, listen carefully to me tonight. Leprosy is a type of sin, and never let the devil deceive you that there's anything pretty or glorious about sin. If not, it's ugly. I believe when God looks down from heaven and sees a soul that's never been saved, this might be what sin looks like to God. Waited too long to come in. Back in the Buddhist leper colony, they're going to feed him seaweed and rice that day. Man eating his seaweed and rice here. Lady's fingers are gone. Her hands will be next when they burst open. Now, the government doesn't care about their hygiene cleanliness, but we're going to keep them clean in the leper colony.
We've got 2 minutes. All right, 3 minutes. We've got 3 minutes now. Tell us about our mission conference. Tell us about Jesus. Just tell us something about the man. Okay?
First of all, thank you. The recounting order she said times I walk in the church and walk out and ask my husband, did you see the preacher's wife? I never met her. And I thank you, Ms. Collins. You know, one of the saddest statements that I've heard traveling around is a wife to say, we were called to the mission field